When we remember my pastor and my teacher, Bishop Hill, she's passed out long ago. I thank God for the teaching that I have received from him.
Yes, Lord.
I thank God for the teaching that I have received from him. And we thank God for being up this second to this. The foundation is more red and verse 14 says that. And I'm going to just look at him, right? And then I'm going to show him off, right? This gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to all nations.
Yeah.
And then
shall the end come.
Yeah. I want to say to you that living a day and time that people need to lighten.
So true.
Living at the end of time, a human being, the light, let me tell you what the light a human being is there. Now, when I'm going to the town, give us there.
Yeah.
I am in a covenant with God.
Write it.
I am in a covenant with God. Here comes the song of me and Jesus. Have a good thing going. A covenant with God. It's not like a covenant with man.
Yeah.
When you go to the bank and you want to have a covenant with the bank, there's something you must have called collateral.
Right.
You don't get nothing from the bank, there, son. Mm. If you could walk into the bank and say, well, 200,000 and I have nothing to back it up. So what made you feel you could walk into God and link up with a covenant with God and have nothing to back it up? Only mouth?
Want see?
Only talk?
Yeah.
Only shout? God is a covenant keeping God.
Amen.
When God signs a covenant with you, you're not to pick it up today.
Yeah.
And you get tired tomorrow, you drop it down. So man, doesn't lie. You're in a covenant with God. You and Jesus have a good thing going. And when the lie didn't get you off, you drop off God.
Oh Jesus.
And you're in a covenant? When you're in a covenant with the bank, and you take the people car, and you fail to pay, they call the bailiff. To embarrass you.
Yes.
What makes you feel that it's different with God? You're riding today. You're riding how, you know?
Yeah.
Come on. Nobody has more spirit than you.
You get the angry chair.
And here comes the light. Get dim. And you get in an area where nobody know you.
Right.
And you're coming and going out the window.
Right.
When God get ready to have a covenant with human being, it's an impossible thing. Let me tell you something. But I tell you, it's hard for God to have a covenant with you. Let me tell you why. You can't dare just now. You might get 80 years again and something so 70 or 60. Yeah. And then you go.
Yeah.
And God's still living. So what you feel is you and God have to have a covenant. Look what God will do. He said, the blessing that I have, Gary, is too big for you alone.
Oh yes.
So God look after Gary. He gets it to Abraham. Say, Abraham, you're going on. You see Ishmael? Yeah, what you know? Because Ishmael is of the born woman. God don't make covenant with anybody, you know? You tie up like a Sunday club. And you sick, you haven't got a covenant? I baptize.
Yeah.
I mourn 20 times.
Yeah.
I go in India, I go in Africa, I go in China. So God want to have a covenant with Abraham. I'm looking at Abraham and I say, Abraham, 90 years, and just now you're going home.
Yeah.
But I want to have a covenant, not just with you, but I want to have a covenant with your house.
Yeah.
Too many believers have covenant with God and the house going down the road.
Oh, Jesus.
You make no sense that they shout. And when you go home, your family living in sin.
Oh, Father.
It makes no sense, man. It makes no sense. You're shouting to the church. And your wife, what? It makes no sense. You are in church on Sunday. And your children are home in front of the TV.
Lord Jesus.
I'll be here by myself. I'll go to your church and come back. Try and try and for me. I need them there. Let me let you know something. When God and you have a covenant, everything under you is in covenant with God too.
Right. Oh Jesus.
Yes. Everything up under your house is in covenant with God because you need it on your house. Just to realize what covenant with God means. He says, for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Yeah. Let me tell you something. As long as the door, with the house in the door that you buy, everybody has to live by God's commandment.
Oh, Jesus. Yes.
You tell me, you the head of the house. Let me stop before I get something to do. We're talking about what is covenant with God, boy. You know why? Because I'm just coming up.
No, we don't have.
I believe I just
said.
Let me tell you something. When God put Abraham aside, he said, yeah, what's going on? I want you to circumcise everything in your house.
Yeah.
I want you to clean up your house.
Yeah.
You're in covenant with God and your house, got you. You're in covenant with God and sin in your camp. You're in covenant with God and today you're shouting. And tomorrow you're whining.
Merci. Merci.
You're in covenant with God. There will be believers that do it. Don't call no names.
Right? Merci.
When believers going to get baptized, or they're going to mourn, or they're going to fast, you know what they do? They take sin.
Yeah, that's right. Let us
go. They put sin down there. Are you going to mourn? Put sin aside, you know?
Yeah.
I have a Thanksgiving next week. Eh? I have to do some fasting. Are you drinking no beer? Are you liming, boy? I have a thing next week, boy.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
You're not going on the morning, John. You're dropping the people, man. You're going to fast. But the minute you're coming from the morning, John, you pick up the people, man. You pick up the bears. You pick up all your bad habits.
Go on, Richard. Go ahead.
Yeah.
What sense it make? You behave yourself just to baptize. Yeah. And when you're done baptized,
that's right.
You come back in the same condition.
What
sense it make? You separate yourself because you're going to give God a sacrifice and next month. Yeah, boy, you come and check me. How much sense I make?
No sense.
I'm going to encourage us today.
Yes.
The time that we're living in.
Oh, yeah.
We're living in a strong time.
That's right. Yeah.
I don't know if you realize, you're not children alone in trouble enough.
Oh, shit. Yeah, this is true. That is true, yeah.
What about the kid, Rowley? Rowley, lockdown, I want to kill Rowley. But I want to let you know the whole world is in trouble.
Really?
And believers just play.
Yeah, this is true. This is true. We are.
And Jesus getting ready to go to the eastern sky.
Yes.
And believers playing, man.
That's right.
Hold on.
God saying, yeah, we are going to be in a covenant with me.
Yeah.
Clean it up now, man.
Yes. We have time to fix.
If you're not coming out with God, clean up.
Yes.
How long hold you between two opinions?
Oh, yeah.
If God is God, serve him now, man.
Oh, yeah.
But if the God that you serve on the other side of the river is God, then serve that God.
Oh, Jesus.
You can't pick up Jesus today, no?
Yeah, no.
Yeah, and chopping up tomorrow, no?
Yeah, yeah.
And pick up Oshun, no?
Yeah.
You can't pick up Jesus today. I pick up Shango tomorrow.
Alright.
You're shouting the Holy Spirit today. And you're dancing with Mama Lata tomorrow.
Thank you. True. Say it again.
I want to let you know today.
But prepare for battle.
If God is God,
I prepare for battle.
Serve him, Mama.
Woo.
Come just today, my God. Jesus is coming soon. I know you're happy, but saying that for a long time. Eh?
Yeah, but he really coming.
Let me let you know something. If Corona really gets serious, I'm gonna see that. If Corona really gets serious in Trinidad and Tobago, which is a little done, we're done.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah.
If Corona gets serious, Yes, in Trinidad and Tobago.
Yeah.
You think 140,000 people, these people?
Yeah.
Yeah, you want that in the States.
Yeah. Check what's going on in Brazil. Right on the corner. Let's go down the back side, go down so which is Brazil. How much you must tell? I want to let you know God has been merciful to us.
Yes, yes, we are.
God has sent me in Trinidad and Tobago.
Yes,
has been merciful to us.
That's right.
That's right. God has been so merciful to us. What should I render now?
Thank
you. Go to the Lord for all his benefits. Let me tell you something. People are at the hospital bed to get in.
Oh, Jesus.
You get someone in a nice chair. You just singing.
Yeah.
Just shouting. You'll get some food just now. Yeah, like nobody hospital, I can't get a bed enough.
Yeah.
You're not corona.
Come on.
And you're sitting there want to give God all, but.
Yeah, you tell me.
Time for believers. Let me tell you something. Drop off sin.
Oh, Jesus.
That's your biggest problem. You know? I want to let you know the sin in my clothes. Nobody didn't walk over behind me. I come to tell you that this sin. Nobody didn't walk over behind me. Nobody here do you nothing. You are no generational curse. Nothing wrong with your husband. Nothing wrong with your wife. Nothing wrong with your children. Your biggest problem is a sin problem.
Yes. Yes.
That's your biggest problem, you know?
Yes.
Sin is your biggest problem.
Yes.
Let me tell you how sin is your biggest problem. For the day I'm a liar till. Let's check the day alone. One liar till. That's your problem? The minute you begin to live righteous, God will begin to remove Satan from you, know? Anytime you get to begin to live on holy ground, you have a problem?
Yeah.
Are you hiding from your wife? She can't see your phone. You're lying. Trust people as friends. They know my man. They're my friend. Lie again. Lie your way. Straight down to hell.
Mossy.
Mommy, he's their friend, mommy. Lie in your way, straight down to the pit of hell. Lie in a big problem. When they get in Revelation, they start to make a list of who can't come in. You know what they put up on the front door?
Yeah.
No liars.
Yeah, that's right. No liars.
No liars, you know?
Yeah.
I swear you can lie.
More see.
And you're going to heaven?
Yeah.
I want to let you know what happened at the gate, a big sign. No. Liars.
Hmm.
I want to call you today. And we continue to worship God. And we continue to serve God. Live righteous, mama.
Yes, Lord. Help us. Yeah.
Do the right thing. In other name, Jesus.